In today's class, we will do division of a decimal number by another decimal number. To divide a decimal number by another decimal number, the first thing we do is to convert the divisor into a whole number. Suppose we have to divide 5.04 by 0.8. As you can see, both dividend and divisor are decimal number. So we can also write it as 5.04 upon 0.8. Now we have to remove this decimal. As we can see, in the divisor there is one place after decimal. So to remove this decimal, we have to multiply the divisor by 10, because when we will multiply this divisor by 10, this decimal will shift one place in the right side, and after that it will be eliminated as there is no other digit. Now if we are multiplying the denominator by 10, that means we have to multiply the numerator also by 10. Then it will be an equivalent fraction. So we have to multiply both numerator and denominator by 10. Now this decimal will also shift one place in the right side. Now this question will be 50.4 upon 8. That means now we have to divide 50.4 by 8. Now the divisor is a whole number. We can directly divide it now. So 50.4 divided by 8. 8 6s are 48. 2 is left. We have now decimal. This decimal will be placed up in the quotient. Bring down 4. 8 3s are 24. Which means answer is quotient equals to 6.3. So what we have to do, we have to check how many places are there after decimal. Then we have to multiply that divisor and dividend by the 10, 100 and 1000 according to the number of decimal places. And then we have to divide in the normal way as we divide whole numbers. Look at the first question here. It is given 5.2 divided by 1.25. So write it as 5.2 upon 1.25. Now as you can see, there are two places after decimal, which means we have to multiply the denominator by 100. Now if we are multiplying denominator by 100, we have to multiply numerator also by 100. In the denominator, this decimal will shift two places in the right side and it will be eliminated. So we will get 125 in the denominator. Now in numerator, only one place is there after decimal, but we have to shift this decimal two places in the right side. So what we will do, we will increase one zero at the right of 2 and then shift this decimal two places in the right side. So it will be 520. Now we have to divide 520 by 125. So here we will write 125 and dividend is 520. 125 4s are 500. Subtract them. 20 is left. Now remainder is 20. No digit is there in the dividend. So what we have to do, write 0.0. Because we can also write 520 as 520.0. We can increase as many zeros as required after decimal. So put this decimal up in the quotient, bring the zero down. Now the number is 200. So 125, ones are 125. Subtract them. 10 minus 5, 5. Here 9 is left. 9 minus 2, 7. Again 75 is left. It is not divisible by 125. So increase one more zero here and bring it down. Now the number is 750. 125, 6 are 750. Remainder is 0. So we got quotient is equals to 4.16. Next question is 1.088 divided by 0.32. So write it as 1.088 upon 0.32. Again, two places are there after decimal in the divisor. So we have to multiply the denominator by 100 and numerator also by 100. So this decimal will be shifted two places in the right side and it will be eliminated. In numerator also, decimal will be shifted two places in the right side. So we have 108.8 upon 32. Therefore, we have to divide 108.8 by 32 now. So 32 and 108.8. 32 threes are 96. Subtract them. 2 left and here 1 is left. Put this decimal up in the quotient and bring down 8. 32 fours are 128. Remainder is 0. So we got quotient is equals to 3.4. Next question is 66.468 divided by 7.64. So we will write it as 66.468 upon 7.64. Again, you can see there are two places after decimal in the divisor. So what we will do, we will multiply the denominator by 100 and numerator also by 100. So when we will divide denominator by 100, this decimal will shift two places on the right side and it will be eliminated. And in the dividend, the decimal will shift two places on the right side and it will be placed after 6. So it will become 6646.8 upon 764. So we have to divide 6646.8 by 764. So 764 8s are 6112. Subtract them. 6 minus 2, 4. 4 minus 1, 3. And 6 minus 1, 5. Now put this decimal up and bring down 8. 764 7s are 5348. Subtract them. 0 is left now. So we got quotient is equals to 8.7. Next question is 9009 divided by 0.13. Now we have to divide a whole number by a decimal number. But the procedure is same as we have to eliminate this decimal from the divisor in the same way as we did in the previous question. So write it as 9009 upon 0.13. Two places are there after decimal, so we have to multiply the denominator by 100 and numerator also by 100. So in denominator, Decimal will be shifted two places in the right side and it will be eliminated. Now 13 is left in the denominator. In numerator, as there is no decimal, we are multiplying a whole number by 100. So what will happen? Two zeros will be increased in the extreme right side of this 9. So it will become 900900. So we have to divide this 900900 by 13 now. 13, 6 are 78. Subtract them. We will get 2 and 1 left here. Bring down 0. 13, 9s are 117. Subtract them. 3 is left. Bring down this 9. 13, 3s are 39. Subtract them, 0 is left. Now these two zeros are left. We can directly put these two zeros in the quotient. Therefore, we got quotient is equals to 69,300. Next question is 672 divided by 0.025. So we can write it as 672 upon 0.025. As you can see, there are three places after decimal in the divisor now. So we have to multiply the denominator by 1000 and numerator also by 1000. When this denominator will be multiplied by 1000, decimal will shift three places in the right side and it will get eliminated. So we can write it as 672 multiplied by 1000 upon 25, because this number will be 25 when the decimal will be removed from it. Now as you can see, we can divide 1000 by 25 directly. So we can also do it as 25 ones are 25 and 25 forties are 1000. Here we can directly divide 1000 by 25. So it can be written as 672 multiplied by 40. When you will multiply 672 by 40, you will get 26,880. Therefore, the quotient is 26,880.